Hey guys, I'm ZSH Plays, and today I'm going to show you how to make your own custom height maps to use in Planet Zoo. So the first thing we need to do is find something cool to make a height map of. So we're here in Google Maps looking at Mount Roraima in Venezuela. If you've seen Pixar's Up, you will know all about this place. Having found it, we need to work out where it is for reasons which will become apparent in a second. So it is exactly on the border between Venezuela and Brazil. And the reason we need to find out where it is because the tool that we're going to use to create the height map, which is called Tangram Height Mapper, unless I'm being particularly stupid, doesn't have any sort of search function. So we're going to jump over to Tangram Height Mapper now. There are links to every app that I use in this tutorial in the description. So we're going to find the exact same spot here, zoom in, and there it is, Mount Roraima. So there's a load of checkboxes on the right-hand side. Don't let them confuse you when you're trying to find where you want to be. Have them all turned on, and then once you've found it, just turn them all off like this. And then we're going to hit the export button, and that is going to generate the height map that we're going to be using in Planet Zoo. Now, once we've got that, we're going to import that into a free app called Canva, which will allow us to edit this exactly how we want it to make the best possible height map. So if you go over to your projects and then uploads and upload the file that we just created, and then we're going to create a new design in the top right, select the custom size option and set it to 1024 by 1024. Then we're going to go back to uploads and drag across the file that we just created and then size that up so it fills this box here. Now obviously you can play around with this to get as much or as little of the height map in as you want, depending on how big you want the final thing to be. So I'm just going to scale this up a little bit. And the way the height maps work is that the brighter the color, the higher the terrain, and vice versa. So we can see the mountain is in white. Now the biggest problem you get with height maps is that when you import them, the edge of the map is often way higher or way lower than the rest of the map, which can leave you with really weird looking borders. So we're going to drop a square onto the map, size it up so it's at the edges, and then change the color to match Planet Zoo's own color that it uses for ground level. So the color that is ground level in Planet Zoo has a hex code, very simple, of 80 80 80. So select the shade of gray that appears when you do that, and this will change this square to the correct ground level color for Planet Zoo. Now if we drag this square across a bit so we can get to the height map behind it, we select the height map and then go to done and edit image. We can now adjust the brightness so that the edges of the map perfectly match the ground level in Planet Zoo, like so. You won't get it all the way around, they'll be using a real feature like this, but we're just going to get it as close as we can. And once we've done that, simply select the square and delete it. We don't need it anymore. And that is your height map pretty much created. Now we need to get it into a format that Planet Zoo will read. Unfortunately, Canva doesn't work with TIFF files, which is the file that you need. So just go to File, Download, and then save it as a PNG. And then go to Google, just type in TIFF Converter, top result, another free app, click on that, select your file, find the file that you just downloaded from Canva, select Convert to TIFF, and then click the Convert button. Once that's done, you can then download the new file, and you need to save this into the Planet Zoo User Height Maps folder. Now this could be in various different places on your hard drive, but User Height Maps, delete the last F from the TIFF, and we are done. We now have a usable height map for Planet Zoo. So we're going to create a new sandbox zoo. Obviously we're going to go with tropical and South America to get that Venezuelan vibe. Go to terrain type and select the height map that you just saved. And then let's create the zoo. And here we have it, your very own tepui in Planet Zoo. I've sized this so it fits in nicely with the ones that are already in the background on the tropical map. Now we just need to do some terrain painting, drop down a few trees, drop down a few more trees, maybe put a waterfall in. Let's get that Angel Falls kind of feel. And there we go. We have Mount Roraima in Planet Zoo. I really hope you found this useful. All the links to every app that I just used are in the description below. If you're still struggling with anything, hit me up in the comments and I'll be happy to help. Thanks for watching.